Today we celebrate the sixth Sunday after Pentecost. In the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark, we have the account of a miraculous multiplication of loaves and fish. There were 4,000 people who were fed miraculously by Jesus. In order to understand the meaning of this miraculous account, we should concentrate ourselves on the very beginning of the Gospel, when we read that Jesus saw the multitude of the people and had compassion on them. This is the very key word to understand the meaning of this miracle. The people were with Jesus since 3 days, and they had nothing to eat. And they were going to go back home now. But Jesus said, if they have nothing to eat, they might faint on the way home. After this, Jesus asks, how many loaves have you got? He asked his disciples. And of course, the disciples were shocked. So many people, you ask us, how many loaves we got? How could we satisfy all this multitude? Jesus is answering this question, is asking this question in order to prepare the apostles for feeding in the future themselves, the great multitude of the believers, not with a miraculous multiplication of loaves as it happens now, but with the miraculous multiplication of the heavenly bread, the Holy Eucharist. This is the reason why Jesus is asking, how many loaves have you got? Get ready to do it yourselves when you will be celebrating the holy sacrifice of the Mass in order to feed all people coming. So there is an inner link between this miraculous multiplication of loaves and the mystery of the Holy Eucharist. Where can we see this intimate bond between the miracle here and the foretelling of the Holy Eucharist? The link is right in this spiritual, internal attitude of our Lord, in having compassion on the people who were without eating anything. In Latin, as we understand in English, compassion, cum patio, means to suffer with. You already hear something about passion, compassion, passion, suffering. To be compassionate means to suffer with another person, to feel in yourself the suffering of the other person. And Jesus is feeling in himself the burden of these people who are there without anything to eat. Jesus is feeling the suffering of these people who have no bread, no bread of life to eat. In another context, Jesus is feeling compassion because they were scattered. They were like sheep without a shepherd. And Jesus moved to compassion on them, fed them, and instituted, eventually, before dying, the holy sacrifice of the Holy Eucharist, to feed us always with this heavenly bread. So the compassion of Jesus is the way we can understand that this miracle now is just a sign for understanding another miracle, the greatest miracle ever accomplished by Jesus, the gift of himself when he became bread of life. Jesus himself is the bread of life. This is great. I am the bread of life. You understand? This miracle is the transformation of a mere piece of bread, simple piece of bread, into the person of Christ. I am the bread of life. How is it ever possible that a simple piece of bread can become Jesus, the Son of God, the living person of our Lord Jesus Christ? From compassion, we move now to the mystery of Jesus' passion, death, and resurrection, which is the way that piece of bread into Jesus' hands became the bread of life, became himself. This transformation is a transubstantiation. But transubstantiation, which means a change of substance from bread into the body of our Lord, his true, real body, there is a need of a change. There is a need of transformation. This is a need of a sacrifice. Without a sacrifice, there is no change at all. There is no passage from bread to the body of Christ, from wine to the blood of Christ. This is the sacrifice of the Holy Eucharist, which is the passion and death of our Lord. The passion is the moment when the sacrifice began. The death is the moment when the sacrifice is consumed on the cross. And this sacrifice is celebrated in the Holy Mass, when we transubstantiate by the word of our Lord, this is my body, this is my blood, that piece of bread and that cup of wine, into Jesus' body and blood. In order to signify this sacrifice, this transformation, in the Mass, in fact, we celebrate, we consecrate first the body of Jesus, we consecrate then the blood of Jesus. Body and blood are consecrated separately. First the body, then the blood. Why? To formally mean the making of the sacrifice. Jesus is sacrificed because the body is separated from his blood. Jesus is on the altar as the lamb sacrificed for us. But that sacrifice is not something that occurs every time we celebrate the Mass. The sacrifice of the Mass is a true sacrifice insofar as it is a representation of the only sacrifice of Golgotha, when Jesus gave up his body and blood once and forever. You see the compassion of Jesus, the wish to suffer for us, to enter his suffering, passion, and death, to be transformed into a gift for us of eternal life. That passion and death, which is the sacrifice of Jesus, transformed Jesus into a gift for us, into a living gift, giving us eternal life. And this is the Holy Eucharist that we celebrate. This is the first reading of this Holy Mass, the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The passion, death, and resurrection of Christ is always, this Paschal mystery is always represented each time we celebrate the Holy Mass. In each Holy Mass, we have the bread of life, Jesus, the bread of life. But we have to take part in this sacrifice of Jesus, and we take part actually first by being baptized, the very first moment to enter this new dimension of Christian life, the life of Jesus, the sacrifice which gives us life, is baptism. Baptism, my dear people, is not just a cleansing, a bath, as Christians, some Christians, understand it to be purified. Baptism is to be, to die with Jesus, to be buried with him, as St. Paul says, we are buried together with him by baptism unto death. But since Christ is risen, we also participate in that resurrection. By baptism, we are buried with him to rise to a new life, according to a new life we receive in baptism. But this new life that we receive in baptism is just initial. It is just the beginning. For the baptism to be completed, we need another sacrament. We need the fullness of Christian life. And this other sacrament, making that life a completely, making that life fully given to us, is the Holy Eucharist. So, from baptism, we come to the Holy Eucharist. It is in the Holy Eucharist that we participate in the passion, death, and resurrection of Christ. Because the Holy Eucharist is right this, the passion, death, and resurrection of Christ. So we now, because have received these two sacraments, are now dead with Christ. We are dead to sin once and forever, since we are baptized and can share in the Holy Eucharist. And we are raised by Jesus to a new life. As Jesus is risen, we are raised up to life, to eternal life. My dear brethren, this is the love of Jesus. This is the compassion of Jesus. All this mystery, baptism, which is the door of Christian life, Holy Eucharist, which is the summit, is the very completion of everything, of our Christian life, is already foretold. In that miracle, Jesus accomplished to feed that great multitude of people. Let us reflect on the compassion of Jesus. If we want to be truly compassionate, what should we do? We should imitate our Lord. And this compassion has always to lead us to appreciate the gift of baptism that we have received, and especially to live properly the mystery of the Holy Eucharist in each Holy Mass we take part in. So let us pray to Jesus to learn from him how to participate in the Holy Eucharist by feeling in ourselves that compassion of Jesus, by being at Mass not just as spectators, being there to stay in a show, to watch a show, or just to be there for a social moment. No, we go to Mass to be compassionate, to suffer with Jesus, and to embrace him when we receive him. My dear people, the very way to be compassionate is manifested especially when you receive Holy Communion. The way the Church is always teaching us to receive Holy Communion is to kneel and to receive it on the tongue. This is the way to imitate Jesus in his compassion, which is again not just a feeling, it is entering his passion, death, and finally resurrection. When we kneel, we imitate Jesus, going into his suffering, into his passion. We humble ourselves. We receive Jesus, and by the power of Jesus, we are raised up to a new life. We receive the bread of life. Kneel down to be raised up by the grace of God. If you prefer just to stand, because this is the way you do not participate in the compassion of Jesus. Let us pray to our Lord to understand how to grow in our faith, how to be truly compassionate as He is for us. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.